Welcome to this video about shrinkage and how to circumvent it. Before talking about shrinkage, we need to understand the concept of conditional distribution for the individual parameters. The conditional distribution is defined for each individual, so let's take the example of the volume of distribution V for an individual called John, for instance. For John, we know the following: his PK data, his covariate values, for instance, his weight that in the model is known to influence the volume. And we also know that John belongs to the population described by the model. This means that John's volume cannot be much larger or much smaller than what is typical for the population John belongs to. Given all this information, we can estimate John's individual volume of distribution. But this value has some uncertainty associated to it. This uncertainty is described by a probability distribution, and this is what we call the conditional distribution. Conditional because it is conditioned on all this. We can plot John's conditional distribution here in red, for instance. The conditional distribution cannot be calculated in closed form, but we can estimate it using samples obtained via Markov chain Monte Carlo. Now, working with a distribution is not so easy, so one usually tries to find a value that summarizes the distribution. It can be the mode, for instance, or the mean. The mode is often used because it represents the most likely value, so the value that has the highest probability. The mode is also called maximum a posteriori, or EBE for empirical bias estimates. Once the EBE value is known, one can easily calculate the associated individual random effect, for instance. These values, the individual parameter and the individual random effect, can then be used to diagnose the model. For instance, to detect correlation between random effects or between random effects and covariates. But these values have a big problem. They can be affected by shrinkage. Shrinkage means that the EBE's values shrink towards a typical population value. It happens when the data is not informative enough to precisely estimate the EBE's. In monoics, the shrinkage is calculated in the following way. To understand shrinkage more intuitively, let's take the example of two parameters, one with shrinkage and one without shrinkage. In this example, the data is sparse and does not permit to precisely estimate the volume of each individual. So the individual volume values are uncertain and the conditional distributions are large. Here, one curve represents the conditional distribution of one individual. If for each individual we take the mode and pull these values together, we see that all values are concentrated around the typical population value. The black curve represents the population distribution. On the opposite, for the elimination rate, we have quite a lot of information in the data for each individual, so the conditional distributions are narrow. If we take the mode of each conditional distribution and pull them together, the values are nicely spread over the entire population distribution. If we pull these values together and draw a histogram, we get something like this. This is the individual parameter distribution plot that can be seen in monoliths. The histogram of individual parameter values is in blue, and the theoretical population distribution is in black. The shrinkage is low for the elimination rate, and the values are nicely spread over the entire population distribution. For the volume, the EBEs have shrinked towards the center and do not properly reflect the variability within the population. And we see that accordingly, the shrinkage is high. This situation is a problem because it will bias all the plots that use the EBEs, such as the correlation between the random effects or the plot individual parameters versus covariate. In this example, it seems that there is a high correlation between the random effects for the volume and for the elimination rate, with a correlation coefficient of 32%. Let's see if this is really true. in monolithics, we have a special technique to go around the shrinkage problem. Instead of using the mode, we use random samples from the conditional distribution, as are denoted here by the stars. If for each individual we draw one sample randomly from the conditional distribution and pull all values together, we see that these values are nicely spread over the entire population distribution, and this is what we want. But we can do even better. We can draw several samples for each individual to have even more points. This is what we do in the conditional distribution task using a Markov chain Monte Carlo procedure. Once this task has been run, Monix will by default use the samples from the conditional distribution, which is this option here. As you can see, the shrinkage has been greatly reduced and the diagnostic plots are now reliable. If we come back to the correlation between random effects, we have more points because we have several samples per individual and we do not see any clear tendency anymore. So the previous plot using the EBs was wrongly indicating a positive correlation, and this is not the case anymore when using the samples from the conditional distribution. So the take-home message is the following. Always use the conditional distribution in the plots because this circumvents the shrinkage problem and makes the plots reliable. If you want more details about the math behind it or how shrinkage is calculated in MonoX versus NonMem, visit our online documentation. See you next week!